Michigan Academy of Environmental Science has been around for 20 years. We're celebrating our 20th anniversary this year. Been around since 1994. We were part of the original charter school movement back in the mid-90s. We're one of the few that are left from that original movement. We individualize our instruction for our students. We really want to reach them as individuals and their levels, challenge, or if they're struggling on something. But we really want to get their interests as well. And one thing that all our students are interested in is getting outside, getting dirty, and learning hands-on. And so how they do that is we have 62 acres on our campus, and they use that to learn about every subject: math, social studies, writing. They might go outside to do a writing piece. They might be reading in our reading garden, or they might be doing a science experiment in our garden.
We have a pond, we have a forest, we have a prairie, a meadow, a garden. So we don't just have classrooms with four walls around them, but we have many different spaces for the kids to learn in an environment. Right now in science, we're talking about life cycles. So life cycles of animals, insects, plants, trees. So instead of just watching a PowerPoint or looking at a book, we can actually come out and see the life cycles. So we took a walk in the woods and we looked for different parts of plants and trees that showed those life cycles, and we collected about 800 acorns because those are so fun. So then we were able to take those acorns back to class, and then we used them in math as counters. Next we're going to dry out the acorns and paint them as an art project.
So math, if you're the younger grades, let's say kindergarten, I always give this example to parents. Instead of being inside and counting dots on a worksheet of 10, they're learning to count to 10 or 20 or 30, the teacher might take them out during the fall and say, why don't you find 30 leaves? And if a student can find 30 leaves and bring them to the teacher, we know they can count to 30. Instead of them sitting inside, doors closed, windows closed, they're out in the fresh air and using the environment around them.
This is history class, U.S. history. We're studying Native Americans' part in U.S. history. Today we're out here investigating what some of the materials that the Native Americans would have used to create homes, for building structures. We're working on a mud oven today that's made of a material called cob, which is clay, sand, and straw. And we're doing some reinforcing on the original materials that were on there.
We had sand, we have clay, we did buy the straw, but we probably could have very easily just used prairie grasses, right? But what we need to do is we need to make this stuff so it mixes well with our little slurry. So we can use our giant cheese grater here. See how I do this? It's nice and dry, and it just shreds it right up. What was our ratio that we needed to use?
2 to 1.
2 to 1. So I've got a half a bucket of sand right there. How much clay do I need?
Two buckets.
Wait, no. Half a bucket.
I mean a bucket.
A bucket, exactly. Yeah.
So we need to get mud on.
What the entrepreneurship program is, it's a chance for seniors to start their own business right in high school. The difference here, though, is the business is focused on starting a sustainable business that solves a problem in the environmental product life cycle. So they look for recycled materials or a way to reuse old materials to make a new business. Some of our students have taken reclaimed wood, for example. So old wood pallets are wood that's been thrown away, and they've taken that wood, they've repurposed it, sanded it down, made their own stain out of some vinegar and some rusty nails, and they've been able to use that old material that was thrown away to make new benches, tables, coat racks, and with that they're able to generate a profit. So that's the main focus of our school, the environmental science theme. Each of the students has to develop a business based on the triple bottom line, which is taking care of the environment, taking care of society, and generating profit. So they complete a lot of research on how their products will benefit or save pieces of the environment, along with benefiting society and generating a profit at the same time.
You don't need 62 acres. We're very lucky to have those 62 acres, but you can do sidewalk chalk on your sidewalk or in your parking lot. You can collect grass and leaves outside on your playground. Anybody can do this type of learning. It doesn't have to be a focus of your school, but they can throw it into a curriculum.